Hey, glad you could join me. As you can tell by the title of this video, we're going to talk a little bit about finances. And maybe I can give you some tips and tricks of how you can get out of debt, if you're in debt. Because I know I was in debt, up to here in debt. And it took some time. But, you know, it's hard to be in debt when you're trying to live the coolest life. So let me start by saying I am not out of debt. What I do have is a house payment. I will say I'm paid way ahead on my house payment. I could probably miss the next six payments and they won't come repossess anything. But so I am way ahead. However, it is not paid off. But that is the only payment I have. What? No credit cards? Nope. Zero. I have credit cards, but they're all zero balances. And I don't try to fall into that old thing about, well, you know, I get points, and if I pay it off in full. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, that's a nice little trap. That's a nice little trap. Most people, what's going to happen is you're going to start putting some money on that, and then all of a sudden the next month comes around, it's like, well, so-and-so happened, and this came up, and I really wanted to go to the beach or whatever, and so it's just an extra month, and pretty soon it's two extra months, and it's three extra months, and you're paying interest on what happened in the past. Essentially, you're borrowing from your future to pay for your life now. It's better to borrow or try to collect what you've got now and pay for your future. I mean, it's cheaper. It's a whole lot cheaper. In what way? Interest alone. It's a whole lot cheaper. So keep that in mind. Now, what happened to me? How do I know so much about this? I essentially follow the Dave Ramsey school of thought, which is use the snowball effect and pay on your expenses. And here's how you do that. Say I got four credit cards, okay? So I find the one that has the least interest rate on it. Nope. I find the one that I owe the least on. Say it's this one. If I owe the least on, I pay minimum payments on these three, whatever that is. Make your minimum payment here. Not a dime over, not a dollar over. Make your minimum payment here. Take all your extra money and kill this one. Now, before you even do that, you've got to start by not using them again. That's going to be tough. That's going to be tough. You need to not use them again. Dave Ramsey thought basically says the first thing you should do is save $1,000 as quickly as possible. Now, how are you going to do that? One, quit spending as much. Because the basic thing of it in getting out of debt is you got to do one of two things. Either increase your income or decrease your outgo. Now, if you do both of those, it happens even faster. So do those things. So the point here is to put $1,000 in your savings account as quickly as possible. Now, why would you want to do that? Well, in case something happens. You didn't realize you're going to have a blowout on your car tire or whatever. Emergencies happen, okay? So do that. Get $1,000 as quickly as possible. Sell something. Sell something. Have a yard sale. And get rid of some stuff that you really don't need. Sell something. Sell a bunch of things. Look up in your attic and find anything that is 2 years old. Those are easy. What do you got on top of your closet that's 2 years old that you haven't used in the last 2 years? Sell it. You don't need it, obviously. You haven't used it in 2 years. If you really want to push the envelope, anything that's over 1 year old, sell it. Doesn't matter what it is. Sell it. Okay? Maybe you get a bunch of old big pictures and stuff like that, not of people, but of, say, of some type of art, and you got it all wrapped up. Sell that thing. It's not doing anybody any good in the attic. Let someone else enjoy that item. Sell it. Clear out your attic. Currently, my attic is empty. The only thing I would possibly put up in the attic would be holiday supplies, like Christmas decorations or whatever. You know, that makes sense. You're going to use those again. But if it's a year old, it's gone. My attic, the house I live in now, zero, empty. Nothing up there but boards to put things on for the next people that buy my house. All right, so where are we at now? What you can do is reduce your outgo and pay off that bill there. So get that first one paid off. Now, this is those four debts that you have, those four credit card debts. Find the one, again, as a review, find the one you owe the least amount on. Say it's only $1,000. Get that one paid off. Paid off as quickly as possible. Understand something. You didn't get this way overnight, did you? Didn't happen one night. It wasn't one night in Vegas that all these four credit cards got maxed out. No, I doubt that happened. Could have, possible, but the odds are it didn't. It happened a little over time. It kind of snuck up on you. It's not fair, is it? Hey, let's just say this. You did it to yourself. Take responsibility and admit to that. And now take responsibility and do something about it. Pay that credit card off. Once you get that one paid off, you go to the next one that you owe the least amount on. Maybe it's this one. Take the money that you were putting here and put it on top of that minimum payment that you were paying here. So this one's gone. And now pay this one off and do the same thing. It's called the snowball effect. So hopefully the money that you were paying on this one plus the money you're going to pay on this one here is going to get some paid off even faster. Okay? Once that happens, go to the next one. Say it's that. No, say it's this one. Say it's this one. So this one here, you're going to pay everything you've got on this one here. It's going to take some time. But again, you didn't get here overnight. You didn't get in this debt overnight. It gradually. This will happen gradually. Start today. Not a New Year's resolution, a today resolution. Start today and say, I'm going to get these credit cards paid off. And then you're going to do your loans. And then you're going to do the same thing with your car. The exact same thing. If you're owing $30,000 on your car, you probably should sell it. You probably should sell it. You should probably get rid of it. If you're serious about getting out of debt, get rid of it. Go get you a used car. Pay, say, $5,000 or less. As a matter of fact, Dave Ramsey says, take some cash. If you can't afford to pay cash, you don't need it. He says, buy a $500 beater is what he says. Ask around for friends that have an extra car they're trying to get rid of. Someone might even give you one. You never know. But take that car, keep it for 1 year, pay off all these other debts, stash some money aside, take the car that you had, the $500 beater, and take some money with it, and go upgrade your car and pay cash. And do the same thing the next year, and the next year, and the next year. Pretty soon, your cars will be paid off. What did I do? I had a Jeep Cherokee that I owed, I don't know, $9,000 on it still. It was a 2015? Anyway, the point is, I had this Jeep Cherokee. I started paying on it, and I was like, you know what? I'm just going to get this thing paid off as quickly as possible. I used the snowball effect, paid it off about 3 years earlier than what was projected. I then took it and traded it in, got my cash. I bought a Jeep Wrangler, which is what I wanted, paid cash for it. You know how much cheaper your insurance is if you pay cash for something? You don't have to get full coverage. Why would I want to get full coverage on a Jeep Wrangler it's way over 5 years old? I got liability and maybe a little extra, but, you know, to each his own, whatever you want to do. So the point there is the car I'm driving in now, this is a, I don't know, 2017 Kia Forte. I own this car. I don't make a payment on it. I did that through the snowball effect, through the Dave Ramsey thing. So once you get those debts paid off, the next thing you need to do is continue to attack and continue to put money in savings. Increase your net worth. And look for investments. Always look for investments. Bitcoin is going crazy right now. I'd highly recommend you putting some money in some electronic currency like Bitcoin. I'm not saying $10,000, but $100, $200. Highly recommend that. But that's something on the side. That's not something you're going to depend on. It's about like buying a lottery ticket. Don't depend on that income, but just put that money aside. But your main focus should be getting out of debt, because you're losing so much money. You're losing so much money on interest. Interest is a ripoff, especially home loan interest. Oh my gosh. It's probably the worst deal ever is home loan interest. Because what you end up doing is those house payments, you get a 30-year loan. Look what they call your amortization chart. Oh my gosh, it's horrible. the way it's set up. It's sad that that's just the way the loan area of our society works, and it's like that worldwide, really. It's people that are making the most money are loan institutions, partially because they get people default on their loans and they lose money that way, so they make it up on people like you. Yeah, it's sad. Anyway, I hope this helps. I hope that this gives you some ideas, and hopefully, in time you can get out of debt, or at least be more out of debt by this time next year. Set a goal. You're gonna get 2 credit cards paid off by this time next year. That's not a bad goal, no matter how much you own those credit cards. But I hope this helps. Be sure to like and subscribe to this video. Put some comments down below. Give me some. Tell me some things that you've done to get yourself out of debt. One thing you can do, and I want just as a little tidbit, is start your own business. A friend of mine said, "Hey, who should I use as a resume writer to because I'm looking for another job?" I said, "Dude, don't get a resume writer. Start your own business. Figure out something that you can do and work for yourself. That's the way to go. I own my own business now. It's only about 8 months old. Doing well so far. I've got an RV inspection business, and it's doing well. Got certification. Got everything set up. Got an LLC set up. It's all really not all that difficult. Bank accounts, credit cards. I can take a credit card. So it's possible. It's doable. You can do something like that. Start your own business. Be thinking of something that you enjoy. I always enjoyed RVs. But be thinking of something you can enjoy, something that you can do on the side, and then pretty soon make it your full-time occupation. Well, hey, this is Tony, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, leave some comments down below and give me some suggestions for future videos. Maybe I'll do some more like this. You never know. Anyway, you need to get out of debt, because that's the only way you're ever going to live the coolest life.